हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन द न्यूमेरिकल मेथड्स। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ वी कैन फाइंड द इनिशियल हाउ वी कैन सॉल्व द इनिशियल वैल्यू प्रॉब्लम विद द हेल्प ऑफ आइलर्स मेथड। ऑल्सो वी विल डिस्कस द सम न्यूमेरिकल एग्जाम्पल। माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर गर, वर्किंग इन द स्कूल ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स थापर इंस्टीट्यूट इंडिया। यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट मी ईदर ऑफ माई ईमेल आईडीज आर देयर इफ यू फील एनी डाउट रिलेटेड टू दिस कोर्स। सो वट इज ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस लेक्चर इज दैट वी विल सी हाउ वी कैन सॉल्व द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन numerically and the problems related to them, like here how you can solve this problem, how you can find the value of this y at 0.5 for this differential equation, and all this problem with the help of Euler's method. So we will see a very shortcut tricks how my main aim is that we will try to complete this table, and you can see the solution of this problem is here. So this is a simple way we can discuss about that, how we can complete this table, that we will see in our this short video is there. So let's start with this one. So we will firstly look about the brief theory about the Euler's method, so that you may understand that how this method will be able to help you to solve the differential equation. So if you consider any of the first order differential equation, like here dy by dx is f of xy, provided the initial condition is here, then there are the numerous methods available to solve this differential equations. First one is the Picard's method, Euler, modified, Runge-Kutta, and so on. So in this lecture we will see how this Euler method will help to solve this problem. So what is the Euler method? It is the single step method which are helpful for solve the ordinary differential equation. It is one of the oldest and the simplest method to solve this problem. What is that? Is that in this Euler method we will start with some starting point. What is that starting point? Is that is the initial point is given to you, like y value at a point x0 is given to be y0. For example, like say y of 1 is my say 3. What is the meaning of that? Is x0 is my 1 and y0 is my 3. So starting point is 1 and 3, and once we will take the starting point and the slope of the curve, what is the slope of the curve? Is you can see that the first order differential equation is here. So once you know what is the meaning of the dy by dx, this is a slope. It means this f of x comma y is nothing but the slope of the curve. So once you know this starting point x0 and xy0, you can substitute the value here, you will get the initial slope. Then this method will explore the solutions by using the various step size. So we can see how you can find the value of the y at any particular value where xi is my here. So make sure that this method is applicable only when you have the step size of equal length. So of equal length. What is the meaning of this equal length? Is we call as h is my step length, and we will see that. So once you will integrate this equation, you will get this h. Once you will integrate this equation, you can integrate from y0 to y. This is f of xy of dx. So you will integrate from x to x. So you can see on the left hand side, what is that? This is y minus y0 is nothing but here. So in order to find this value, you can see this value is here. Now I can discretize the intervals, like here this is my x. So I can discretize the interval x0, x1, x2, and so on. And this is the value of the fx and so on. So I can substitute the value firstly in this range, like here. I can firstly find in this range and then find in this range and so on. So let assume that in this particular range the value of the fxy is fx0 y0. So if you substitute this value in here, what you can see, this value is my constant with respect to x, so it can be taken outside. So the integration of 1 is my here. So what is the value of the x1 minus x0 is h. Similarly, you can find the in the range of this. You can take instead of the x0, y0, you can take as x1, y1. Again, this part is constant. Again, you will get here and so on. So in general, it can be written as here. And this is the formula for finding the Runge-Kutta methods. For the Euler's method. That is for the first order differential equation, where xi plus 1 is this. So based on this, we will be able to solve these four numerical examples in a very simple and efficient manner. Look at that. You have to solve this Euler. You have to solve this differential equation with the initial point here, and step size is given to be this one. So it means you start from the zero, your target is to reach at the point 0.1 with the step size of 0.025. So this means this plus this, again with the help of this, this is 0.50, then 0.075. So it means how many steps you want to take is 5 steps are there. So what is that given to you? If you compare this differential equation with the help of here, what is the value of the fxy? Fxy is nothing but y minus x upon here. And this initial point is given to you as x0 is 0, y0 is nothing but my 1. So my target is to complete this table. And it's a very simple, I will tell you in the shortcut manner. The first one is the value of the x. What is the initial value is? 0. What is the initial value of y is? 1. So you can write this value as a 0 and 1. So you can substitute this x and y in here, value of the fx. What is the value of this? This is 1 minus 0 upon 1 plus 0. The answer is my 1. Now you can use this value, that is a y plus h time. What is the h is my here. So that is how you can compute this values. This is y plus 0.025 of the fx1. So what is the answer of this is my here. Now in the next step is, this is 0, so it will be my 0 plus h. That's the second length is 0.025. How you find the value of the y at here? This value is nothing but this computed value. That's a new y. That is here. The initial value is previous value plus of the h is here. This value is nothing but my here. That is 1.025 is written this value. And once you know the x and y, now the process will be repeated again and again. You can compute this value as here, this minus this divided by 1.025 plus 0.025. So after the calculation, you will get this. And how you can compute these values? What is the value of the y is here? 1.025. What is the value of the h is 0.025. And what is the value of the fxy is 0.9524. So you can substitute here. You can get this value. What is the next value is? Again, the previous value plus of the h. So what is the value of the h is here? So once you will get this value is this. What is the value of y is? This new calculated value. You can write this new value here. Again, x and y are here. You can substitute the value of in fxy. You will get this value. And again, you can see this value plus 0.025 of this value. You will get this value. And since my target is up to that 0.1, so it is not the 0.1. Again, you can plus h. This previous value, you can take new value as here. This value you can take substitute in here. And similarly, you can get here. Again, at the next value, you can get this value 0.1, this value, and so on. So now my target is to calculate the value at 0.1. It is achievable. So therefore, what's the value of the 0.1? The corresponding value of the 0.1 is here. That is 1.0933 is the requirements. So this is the way you can complete this table. Look at the second example, which will help you to understand the method more. So perform the Euler's method, compute the value at 0.5. H is not given to you. So if H is not given to you, how you can compute them? So firstly, you have to compare this value. Now h is not given to you, you can consider h by your own, or else you can consider h is, what is the final value is here, minus what is the initial value is 0, and how many steps you want. That's again not given to you, so I assume I can take h, compute the 5 steps. So it means here you can consider instead of this here as 4 also, you can consider here as a 7 also, that's depending upon you. This 5 is the number of the steps you want to execute. So I want to execute the 5 steps, so h is my 5. So I start from here. Initial value is my 0, h is my here. So what is the value of the fxy is? You can substitute the value here. This is 1, and once you will calculate here, so it value is, previous value is 1 plus what is the h is? I can consider h as my 0.1 of 1. So this value is my 1.1. So I can consider h is my 0.1. What is the next value is? You can say xi is previous value plus h. This value is taken as this value. I can calculate this value by substituting here. You can see, and similarly you can compute this value. Once you will see, now you can find this new value 0.2. this value is taken as previous value. Substitute this value here and this value. Next value is my 0.3 because I have to take h as my 0.1. So what is the value of this is 1.36484. That is a previous value. And you can compute the value of this and this. Similarly, 0.4, this value here, you can substitute this value. And finally, you need the value at 0.5. Once you will reach here, you can compute this value if you want. And finally, you will get, you can complete them. But since we need the value at the 0.5, so what's the answer of the 0.5 is here. So that's the required answer. So that's a very simple manner. Look at one more example is there. Again, you have to use this differential equation. H is given to you and you have to find the value from 1 to the 1.5. Again, the same rule is there. We will firstly calculate here. What is the value of the H is given to you? 0.1. So we will start this table. The first value is 1. X is my 1. Y is my 5. So what is the value of this is X into Y. That is 5. You can find this value here as 5. How you can calculate this is Y is 5. H is my this. What is the value of the Fx is here? So what is that? 5.5. Now H is my 1.5. So what is the next value is? 1.1. What is the value of Y is? Here. So once you will know this value of T2, you can complete this value and here. Similarly, you can proceed in the similar manner. 1.2, this previous value, you can complete them and so on. Now my target is to find the solution at the point 1. What is the solution at the point 1 is 5. What is the solution in between them? 1.1. As this is answer. So that is, what is the value of the 1.1 is 1.5. What is the answer of the 1.2 is my 6.1050. What is the value at the 1.3 is 6.8376 and so on. Look at the one more example. Last example is here. You have to solve this differential equation in the range 0 to 0.5. That is again here. So again H is not given to you. So you that's depending upon you. You can take an as a 0.025 also. But you can see if you take H as this, how many steps are there in order to start from here to reach at this point. There are so many steps are there. So that's depending upon you, whatever you want to take the H. So since I need the 0 and 0.5, so I consider H as my 0.1. So once you will solve this, you can see the results are computed like this way. The value at x0 is starting point, 0, 0. Fxy, you can substitute this value here. And new fx is, new value of y is this. Similarly, you can find the x plus h, 0.1. Previous value here. Once you will x square plus y square and so on, you will get the required answer. It means what is the value of the 0 is a 0. What is the value at 0.1 is? What is the value of the 0.1 is 0. The value at the 0.2 is my 0.001 and so on are the required solutions by using Euler's method. So I hope you can enjoy this session too. We will see how you can construct the MATLAB code of this method in our next class. Till then, you can simply follow this numerical method playlist in the channel name Dr. Garg, where you can find the various MATLAB codes and as well as theory for the regular falsi, bisection, secant, Newton, Gauss elimination, Jordan and many more are there in this channel named Dr. Garg. You can find this link from here. Till then, you can share this video. Best of luck, students. Happy learning.